Thanks, Ken Corlett. Taoiseach, last week's Web Summit demonstrated the huge opportunity to Ireland of digital technology. And obviously it's very important for our economic recovery and future prosperity that we are global leaders in technology and critically are recognised as such internationally. But unfortunately there is a very important piece of government policy which is putting this at risk. And this is the continued reduction in funding to third level institutions, to our colleges and universities. Now, this year, as you know, Taoiseach, government funding to our third level institutions is going to fall by 25 million euro. Now, Taoiseach, we all welcome new jobs like those announced at the Web Summit. But if we want to see these kind of announcements continue into the future, we've got to start having a very honest conversation about what is happening in education in this country. Now, in the same week of the Web Summit, the OECD released a report on adult education in Ireland. And what it shows should be taken very seriously. It shows that out of the 24 countries assessed, in literacy we came 17th of the 24. And even more worrying for the future of technology in Ireland, in numeracy, we're ranked today, Taoiseach, 19th out of the 24 countries. Now, 3 years ago, we had two universities in the top 100 in the world. We now have none. And the one university which managed to move up the rankings this year, UCD, it got up to 161st place. Here's what the president of UCD, Dr. Hugh Brady, said in response. He said, and I quote in the Irish Times, "A tipping point has been reached. The state must now either choose to empower its higher education institutions to compete with the world's best or continue to pursue a policy of central command and control and underfunding." And Taoiseach, I'm not sure people understand the extent of the underfunding. If you track state funding per student to our third level institutions between 2008 and what is projected in 2015 under the government's plan, per student funding will halve. It will halve, Taoiseach.
Thank you.
Now, no country can aspire.
We're over time, thank you.
Ken Corlett, with respect, I'm two minutes in versus
time.
15 minutes.
You're over time, thank you.
Well, I beg your indulgence for 30 seconds.
No, you can't.
If I may.
Will you please adhere to the chair? What's your question?
Taoiseach, we can't continue to aspire to being global leaders in technology and half are for student funding. And I hope you agree with that. Now, Taoiseach, you got a ride in Elon Musk's car to the Web Summit, and I'm sure you heard him say that for technology companies, you must have engineers. So my question is this. Do you agree with Elon Musk, Taoiseach, that for Ireland to continue to build its reputation in this area, we must have engineers and STEM graduates?
Thank you.
Do you agree that those graduates must be among some of the best graduates in the world? And therefore, Taoiseach, do you agree that it is essential that we stop the continued cuts to our third level institutions, and will you reverse the 25 million cut, which is the latest one in this budget? Thank you.
I think Deputy Donnelly last weekend was a signal moment in the sense of Ireland being recognised as being one of the leading centres now globally for the digital tech world. And for all of those who were involved in the Digital Web Summit here in Dublin, it sent out an international message of absolute excellence. And so many of the people whom I met there from all over the world, belie the argument that you make here about the quality of our young people, about the quality of the graduates, about their innovative capacity and their entrepreneurial skills. In fact, many of the smaller companies that I've met there may well explode in the global sense of reach by what they're doing in the next number of years. I agree with you. I agree very much with you that this is an issue that requires some considerable debate here from the Oireachtas. Central command and control has always been in the Department of Education, though when you go through all the third level colleges, the universities and the colleges of technology, they raise very considerable sums outside the remit of the state. And when I look at what's happening in the universities across the country with the expansion in science and engineering and their relationships with various parts of the world, the Far East, Middle East, United States and so on, there are very, very encouraging signs here. I think it's true, Deputy Donnelly, that we do need to get our act together in terms of the colleges of technology for technicians. I think it's important that we supply engineers from our universities and that there be a relationship between the world of academia and the commercial world. The massive online open courses, the MOOCs as they're called, are going to change the way that education is structured over the next decade, where lecturers will not be in a position as heretofore, where they're going to have to become much much more observant mentors of their students because of the vast quantity of information that's now available for any students studying any subject. The relationship there is going to change, I think. But I have to say to you in final, to this part of your question, when I talk to these companies who invest here, our Enterprise Ireland dealing with young companies exporting abroad, and they are blown away by the capacity of our young entrepreneurs to actually measure up. And what they say, Deputy Donnelly, is no matter how you set the bar, the young Irish can meet that challenge. So it is very important that we understand the role and the fundamental importance of having quality engineers come out of our universities, quality technicians out of our colleges of technology, and that we move on in an Ireland sense to get the best out of all of these. So there's very considerable amounts raised outside the state in terms of support for third level colleges. The basis of your case, I think, is one that merits discussion here, because it is all about jobs and opportunities for the time ahead, and I share that sentiment strongly.
Thank you. Deputy Donnelly, 1 minute.
Thank you, Taoiseach, and I'd like to thank you for taking it seriously, and I really would ask you to take a look at this in the current budget. It is one of the things that is going below the radar in this country. Year on year, we are eroding the funding to our third level institutions. Now, the presidents of those universities are saying very loudly, very clearly and very publicly that something has to change. Dr. Hugh Brady has described it as a tipping point. I spoke to the ex-president of one of our biggest universities recently, who described the process of the continued reduction in cuts as the asset stripping of our third level system. We know that our universities are pulling back on teaching resources. We know that they're pulling back on R&D activities. Taoiseach, I was in a fantastic startup company this morning in the Nova Centre in UCD. And what these guys are doing is they're coating material that's going to be used on a satellite that the European Space Centre is going to send up in a while to explore the sun. And I asked them, I said, look, I'm going to be talking to Taoiseach about this later on today. What message would you have? And he said, will you tell him that that this employer is continuing to hire some of our good graduates in spite of government policy?
Thank you.
He said, would you please tell him that we need reinvestment? We need more connection between the small businesses and the universities. But Taoiseach, the universities cannot continue to fuel the future economic growth of this country.
Thank you.
We in this Parliament half the per student funding over a 7-year period. So I very much welcome your response to my question. I ask you in response, will you take a look specifically at the 25 million?
Thank you, Deputy.
Dean, thank you.
The budget will stand, Deputy Donnelly. I'll make this point here. I was in Limerick recently, the University of Limerick, where the J.D. Burnell project is underway. And this is funded in part by the Atlantic Philanthropies to bring in 10 world-class researchers, five of whom are in situ, in respect of a world-famous engineer from NINA many, many years ago. But the project itself it will have very, very significant output. Been in UCD and Trinity and UCG and UCC, all of them are looking forward in their own way to the future here. I'd point out here, Deputy Donnelly, that Grange Gorman, in the city centre here, it will be the forerunner of a new kind of technological university in the country here. And that's why it's important that our colleges of technology get together in terms of their specialities as they see them for technological university status for the future. Very important that they engage with that, otherwise the world will pass us by.
Thank you.
But I see opportunities for huge numbers of technicians out of the IT colleges, and engineers of exceptional quality coming from our universities. And when you relate that to the cluster movement, the world of academia, and the commercial world, the future is very bright here. And all of those people who were at this weekend, last weekend here in Dublin, they see Ireland as really a melting pot for ideas, for change, and for transformation for the future. So let's have a discussion about it in due course here. I respect the sentiment of what you say, but in answer to your question, the budget decision in respect of this will not be reversed.
That completes leaders' questions for today.